So my feedback regarding today is that I think I'll definitely echo what Chrissy said, but also just recognizing as well that there needs to also be more men in the room. I feel like that is so important, especially when we're talking about a topic that also has to do with them. It'll be good for them to be in the room so that they can also tell their peers. I feel like that way the message on tackling this issue would spread. And my takeaway from it is that I'm definitely looking forward to just seeing how everything that was discussed today just manifests in different households, in different communities, in different boroughs as well, because I feel like that's how we start conversations. I feel like that's how we continue to tackle an issue. So I'm definitely looking forward to just seeing how more solutions will appear for the women who are actually going through this as well, and the many more doors that would be open to them getting support as well.
I enjoyed today's event. It was good seeing a diverse range of organisations all addressing different problems in the same sector. It's reassuring to see a lot of good work is happening on a vital issue in the borough.
My feedback from today is that it was amazing to have an event where we could come in, especially as young people, and share the work we've done and share our passion for social justice and change, and especially as young women, to kind of show the journey that we've had and the trust that Lambeth has put on us at YCK to do this project. I think that's amazing. I think another feedback would be it would be good to kind of have more young people in the room to kind of have them involved and their voices heard as well, because it's just me and Jennifer, but we're like 24, 25, but you know, there's a generation younger than us that also deserve to be in the space, because when I work with young people, I realise that they feel left out of spaces and conferences like this, and I feel like their voices should be heard as well. That would be my feedback. My takeaway would be, for me, it's just amazing to see a borough do so much work and have the intention and the will to want to make change and protect women and young girls in their borough, and I think that's amazing what Lambeth have achieved and how they've gone about it and how they've actually really consulted the community in order to do it and given us the power at YCK to do that. It shows that if Lambeth can do it, all boroughs in South London can do it. So that's the takeaway. Thank you so much.
My name's Pam and I'm the best centre manager for women in prison. The best centre is a women's service that supports women involved in the criminal justice system. We have been working with men for a couple of years now to get them involved in men tackling, helping to reduce violence against women and girls. Haven't heard of the Black Men's Consortium before today's event, but it's been fantastic to see the work that they've been doing, and I'd definitely be interested in having a further conversation with you about how we can link up to strengthen this piece of work.
My name's Katrina. I also work for Women in Prison. This is my second time actually seeing a performance from the Black Men, it's a word that I'm tongue-twisted with, so bear with. And I think what I find so interesting is it sparks conversations that we don't generally have, and it's thought-provoking, and I also like when you get to kind of challenge what's happening and kind of how you would do something different. And I enjoyed it once again, and just continue what you're doing, get that message out there, and like Pam said, we look forward to doing something together.
I think a takeaway message from today is that we need to basically, when we say we need more men in the space, we need men that are not attached to organisations. I think that the narrative and the often basically means that men are scared to enter in these spaces unless they're attached to an organisation, which probably gives them some security blanket. But just to get a random person walking in, he probably will walk in here feeling scared, feeling unprotected, feeling like, I can't go into that space, because if I go into that space without being attached to an organisation, that means they may see me as a perpetrator. That means they may see me as a person that is out here committing all these ills. But if you come into these spaces with an organisation, you're seen differently. So I do believe that if we want to be more inclusive and have a space where men can basically strolling to these spaces and learn. We have to think about an approach that is more inclusive, and then we may get a few more men through the doors. For me personally, I will always pay homage and thanks to Pam for allowing me to get into the BEF Centre. Doing that basically not only changed my life, but it also changed my outlook, and it also changed how my organisation functions and how it goes about doing its daily work. But I feel that myself and a lot of the organisations here, we're not a true representation of the men that are out here committing these ills. And I think those we need to make sure that they're here. And so we definitely need to look at how we can have them here and make them feel comfortable coming here, because that's how they will learn. All right?
That to support men with the kind of conversations around their masculinity, around who they are, how they see what manhood means to them, I think that these are things that need to be encouraged amongst men from age of children. I think that that's it. I think, you know, having the courage, being brave, practice standing up for yourself, practice challenging your friends. I think that it's quite clear, like through some of the scenes, that it's almost uncommon or a struggle in men friendships. And I think that that's maybe something that we can all think about if we've got young boys or we're working with young boys, is to try and empower them to have those kind of conversations with each other.
Is work, like, if you just take a look at the room, right now everyone's left, but have a look at this room space. Right. So this hall was full of people. And normally when you have this kind of thing, it's really hard to keep people engaged throughout the whole thing. But as you're watching these people play out roles in which we all have seen, it then starts really holding it home. But not only that, viewers in the audience were invited to come onto the stage after they'd just seen some triggering event that had played out horribly. They were asked to come onto the stage and show how they would act differently. And I think for me, it really holds, because everyone now, you weren't sure if you were going to be selected, right? So you're immediately thinking, how would this play out? So everyone's not just having engaged in something and seen something, they reflect on it. And as I was saying to you, I think what the Black Men Consortium have done has made this particular event unforgettable for everyone that was here. Like everyone that came here today will remember each of the three scenes, they'll remember how it played out, and they'll remember like the actions and what was spoken about, what could be done. So I think I'm still blown away, and I said this to you and all the actors, like the actors did such an incredible job. But I think it's shown me the power of theatre that can bring reality and impact in ways that other things can't. So to you and to the rest of the guys, like,
so
honestly,
you see this, the love is back and forth, representing the BMC, maximum love for our faithful and trusted leader Tony, maximum love for Keith pivoting with the organisational aspects, big love. Big, big, big love to our Errol, nursing his ribs from a car crash as of the early hours of Sunday, coming away from the lovely Simone's 50th birthday party. Shouts to all of the BMC brethren for doing something that can result in an inspirational brother like this, giving such a strong vouch, and love to all.
Peace. My name's Keith, I'm one of the members of the Black Men's Consortium. And a few weeks ago, we were approached by the domestic violence team at Lambeth. We would do a kind of presentation. And yes, that was basically, we said yes. I was a little bit apprehensive because obviously I'm a man, and still every day, two women are murdered by men through domestic violence. And domestic violence is not just about violence, it's about domestic abuse. And domestic abuse also affects children. And it's actually now been recognised that although children may not witness it, but they're there in the room, it is now recognised that they can it can affect them later on in life, which was part of the role that I played as an abusive husband in denial, but putting it down to the fact of I don't want to be like my father, who was an abusive father, and I witnessed that as a child, so it was kind of like history repeating itself. So that was kind of the role that I was playing this afternoon. Like I said, a bit nerve-wracking being in a room full of professional females, and maybe there might be some unfortunate women, I shouldn't say the word unfortunate, some women who may be in a relationship where there is domestic violence, so we were quite mindful about any triggers, but it was still very important for us to portray one type of male, because there are many different men that do display domestic violence against women. Doesn't have to be physical, it could be emotional, it could be sexual, it could be financial and coercive. So I just hope that everybody took from what we did and can discuss that amongst themselves, whether it's in a private setting or in a professional environment.
I think today was very empowering, I think, for everybody. Tony Seeley and his group did some excellent work, and I like that it's not just drama, but it's drama with constructive things that can actually be done. There's solutions there. So it wasn't just drama, there were real solutions that everyone can take away to make a difference, so that there will be less violence against women and girls.
Yeah, so today was amazing. I am the head of service for the Safer Communities team, so we organised today, so really proud to see what everyone's pulled off, and having Black Men's Consortium here and performing was just really beautiful. I was saying, when you have art and performance involved, it just feels like such a different type of event. It feels like we're more driving towards a societal change that we need, rather than just professionals in a sort of echo chamber talking to one another. So I thought that the performance was so powerful, and it was amazing how relaxed everyone was made to feel in the space, and really welcomed to comment, to participate, but it felt really comfortable, and yeah, just really beautiful.